ओ ये संतोष भैया, मैं तो इसमें ले रही हूँ ना, इस कंप्यूटर में। एक मिनट, ओके। सबको बधाई हो गांधी जयंती का और लाल बहादुर शास्त्री। इसलिए मैंने तुमको जल्दी, कुछ लोग बधाई नहीं होता, जन आया तो बस खाना पीना सब छोड़ा, सब लैपटॉप गर्मी से पड़ा हुआ है, मैं दौड़ के आ गया स्कूल में कि मैं यहाँ बच्चों के साथ करूँ। नाउ रेडी स्नेहा,
यस मैम।
ओके। मैं जरा तुम लोग का लिस्ट निकालू, मैं कब से बैठी हूँ आके, आई तो 2 o'clock ही और क्लासेस है, आ गई। चलो
मैम
एवरीबॉडी
अभी 2 मिनट बचा है 2 बजने में।
रेडी, ये 3:02 हो गया ना, 3 बजे तुम्हारे, 3:02 हो गया,
अभी
स्टार्ट
तो
करो।
58 हुआ है मैम,
नहीं
बहुत सारे बच्चे अभी आए नहीं है।
कोई बात नहीं, 3 बजे जो
58
टाइम
हुआ है
है,
अभी
टाइम
तो,
के हिसाब से कंप्यूटर
58
का टाइम
बच्चे।
3 बज रहा है। स्टार्ट करिए, कौन नहीं आया वो हमारे लिए नहीं, अभी मैं अटेंडेंस रिकॉर्डिंग करूंगी, वो आ गए तो आ गए, नहीं आए तो नहीं आए। 3:02 कंप्यूटर टाइम दे रहा है। ठीक है बेटा, स्टार्ट।
यस मैम। मैम गाना ही स्टार्ट करूं?
यस, आप पहले प्रेयर से ही शुरू करेंगे, आज पढ़ाई
यस
तो होनी नहीं, गांधी जी के बारे में बात कर रहे हैं, इसी चक्कर में हमारा नेशनलिज्म इन इंडिया भी थोड़ा सा रिविजन हो जाएगा। चलो, तुम लोगों ने कल
यस मैम।
विद्वानों को किया जाके बोला था, मैम ने बहुत सारे काम दे दिया, काम करने के लिए ही तो आते हैं, हम काम नहीं करेंगे तो फिर क्या। चलो स्टार्ट, एनी वे मैं नेवर माइंड, मुझे कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता। चलो
वैष्णव जन तो तेने कहिए जे, पीड़ पराई जाने रे। वैष्णव जन तो तेने कहिए जे, पीड़ पराई जाने रे। पर दुखे उपकार करे तोए, मन अभिमान नाने रे।
लाओ
वैष्णव
लाओ,
जन तो तेने कहिए जे, पीढ़ पराई जाने रे। सकल लोक मां सहुने वंदे, निंदा ना करे के नीरे। वाच काच मन निश्चल राखे, धन धन जननी तेनी रे। वैष्णव जन तो तेने कहिए जे, पीर पराई जाने रे। वैष्णव जन तो तेने कहिए जे, पीर पराई जाने रे।
वेरी गुड अनुष्का
थैंक यू।
रामधुन, थोड़ा लाउडर करो, उसको मुंह के पास रखो सब, ये स्नेहा का थोड़ी कभी ज्यादा हो रहा था पर फिर भी अच्छा है। चलो
साईराम
हम
जोहर,
मिल,
साईराम जोहर, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू सिंग राम धुन इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू ऑल। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट्स नो अबाउट दिस। द ओरिजिनल लिरिक्स ऑफ दिस ट्रेडिशनल सॉन्ग वाज व्हिच वाज लेटर कॉल्ड राम धुन वाज ओरिजिनली रिटन बाय श्री लक्ष्मणाचार्य एंड इट वाज इंक्लूडेड इन द नाम रामायण। गांधी जी मेड सम मॉडिफिकेशन इन इट सो एज टू एनहांस पीपल्स डिवोशन टू द डिवाइन पावर एंड And also in order to unite the people of the country. It was then composed by Vishnu Digambar Paluskar. Mahatma Gandhi, along with his supporters, sang this in the 241 miles march to Dandi, which we call the Salt March.
Originally written by
Sri Lakshmanacharya.
Sri Lakshmanacharya. And last में आपने एक नाम बोला किर्लोस्कर ना क्या है?
विष्णु दिगंबर पालुस्कर.
एक मिनट. विष्णु दिगंबर. स्पेलिंग बोलो पालुस्कर का.
PALUSKAR.
एक मिनट.
PALUSKAR.
के फॉर काइट. अनुष्का पालुस्कर. फिर से
पालुस्कर. KAR.
क्या बोलो पूरा शुरू से बोलो. पी से बोलो.
PALUSKAR.
Okay. What he has done, Vishnu Digambar Paluskar?
Ma'am, he has composed the Gandhian one.
He has composed?
The Ramdhun.
Okay. But it is written by Sri Lakshmanacharya.
Yes, ma'am. And then there were some modifications done by Gandhiji.
Vishnu Digambar Paluskar composed the Ramdhun. That's it. Chalo.
Ma'am, can I start?
Tum pehle se dobara se padho isko thoda sa. Just read it.
Okay, ma'am. The original lyrics of this traditional song, which was later called the Ramdhun, were written by Sri Lakshmanacharya, which was included in the Naam Ramayan. Gandhiji made some modifications in it so as to enhance people's devotion to the divine power and also in order to unite the people of the country. It was composed by Vishnu Digambar Paluskar. Mahatma Gandhi, along with his supporters, sang this in the 241 miles march to Dandi, which we call the Salt March.
Okay, now Mustafa.
Raghupati Raghav Raja Ram Patit Pavan Sita Ram. Raghupati Raghav Raja Ram Patit Pavan Sita Ram. Sita Ram, Sita Ram, Raj Pyare Tu Sita Ram. Sita Ram, Sita Ram, Raj Pyare Tu Sita Ram. Raghupati Raghav Raja Ram Patit Pavan Sita Ram. Raghupati Raghav Raja Ram Patit Pavan Sita Ram. Ishwar Allah Teru Naam Sabko Sanmati De Bhagwan. Ishwar Allah Teru Naam Sabko Sanmati De Bhagwan. Raghupati Raghav Raja Ram Patit Pavan Sita Ram.
Good, very good, excellent. Next, Shreya.
Yes.
Satyagraha, what is it?
Yes.
Yes, Shreya. Choda loudly bolo.
Yes, Satyagraha. Gandhiji's concept of Satyagraha is an exceptional and novel way to resist against the evil.
Just look at the paper.
Gandhiji's concept of Satyagraha is an exceptional and novel way to resist the evil. This is the heart and soul of the Gandhian theory and philosophy and his exclusive contribution to the modern Indian political thought. Through this mechanism, Gandhiji aimed at resisting any kind of unjust, impure, and untruthful acts. This concept also aims at furtherance of love and self-purification. Satyagraha can be regarded as a vindication of truth by
keep the speaker, yes, so that the sound will be loud.
The concept also aims at furtherance of love and self-purification. Satyagraha can be regarded as the vindication of truth by taking self-suffering in the form of love. It is the weapon of the bravest and the strongest. It is an antidote for coercion. It was believed that Satyagraha enables elevation of spiritual and moral qualities of an individual. The main function of the Satyagraha was not to injure the enemy by any means. It is an appeal to the enemy either through reason or by a gentle rational argument. It is something like a sacrifice of the self. Satyagraha has two positive features. Firstly, it showers blessing on those who practice it, and secondly, it blesses those individuals against whom the Satyagraha is practiced.
So many people are behind us this thing. चलो श्रेय कंटिन्यू बेटा
यस
हो गया
द कांसेप्ट ऑफ सत्याग्रह एडवोकेट्स दैट इट इज थ्रू सफरिंग दैट देयर आर अचीवमेंट्स फॉर इंस्टेंस जस्ट लाइक अ मदर हु टेक्स ऑल द सफरिंग फॉर द सेक ऑफ अ चाइल्ड सत्याग्रह आल्सो टेक्स ऑल द पेन फॉर द कॉज ऑफ ऑल द फेलो सिटीजंस दिस आइडियल आल्सो एक्सपांडेड that there is a direct relationship between the purity of the suffering and the extent of progress. It believes that the purer the suffering, the greater the material and spiritual progress. The theory of Satyagraha has three main purposes. Firstly, it purifies the sufferer. Secondly, it intensifies favorable public opinion. And thirdly, makes a direct appeal to the soul of the oppressor. Gandhiji differentiated between the terms Satyagraha and passive resistance. The former, according to him, is the moral weapon and the latter is the political weapon. The victory of the soul power over the physical force is reflected in the idea of Satyagraha. The former is dynamic while the latter is static. The ultimate aim of Satyagraha is to achieve success despite his extreme suffering with cheerfulness and love. Cheerfulness and love, unlike passive resistance, that is undertaken in a situation of weakness and despair. Ultimately,
No comments on Gandhi Jayanti. What is really your idea? Okay, beta. Srishti, कुछ भी लिख रही हो तुम? ये record हो रहा है, मालूम है तुमको? Yes, हो गया चलिए. और बचा
yes,
है
मैम थोड़ा सा ही बचा है
तो बहुत जल्दी करो
ग्रह ऑफर्स अ सब्सटेंशियल एंड इफेक्टिव ऑपोजिशन टू इनजस्टिस एंड टायरनी इन कंपैरिजन टू पैसिव रेजिस्टेंस थैंक
यू ओके थैंक यू वेरी गुड सो क्लैप फॉर अ ओके नाउ
रिसीवर
स्पीकर पढ़ो रीड करो पढ़ो बोलो श्रेया दैट वाज एक्सीलेंट वेरी वे बहुत अच्छा तुम लोग ओवरनाइट काम किया और एक चीज अच्छा नहीं कि तुम लोगों ने बोल दिया यू कैन डू यू हैव पोटेंशियल दिव्यों को बोल दिया बहुत सारा काम दे दिया भाई काम कौन सा काम अभी तो मैं अभी काम बचा है यस को दूंगी मैं काम यस शुड आई गिव यू सम वर्क
श्योर
अभी जब तक इनका चल रहा है आप लाल बहादुर शास्त्री के बारे में बता थोड़ा सा कुछ भी तुम अपना कलेक्ट करो और फिर बोलो कल मुझे ध्यान नहीं आया उनके बारे ओके प्रियांशी वाइस है
अभी
वो है डू समथिंग यस
ओके
ओके प्रियांशी
यस मैम
कोई भी चार्ट में कुछ भी नहीं लिखेगा इधर बाउ माउ हाउ गा लिखो वाइस और सत्याग्रह
यस मैम
सत्याग्रह
ओम श्री
ये बोलने के लिए बस ऐसे सीधा बोलो.
ओके मैम.
आई एम प्रियंसी पोचरी गोइंग टू टॉक ऑन दिस ऑन द ओकेजन ऑफ गांधी जयंती. ये सब बोलो.
ओम श्री साई राम.
रिकॉर्ड हो रहा है.
Om Shri Sai Ram and a happy Gandhi Jayanti to all of you present over here. Today, on the occasion of Gandhi Jayanti, I, Priyanshi Pachauri, am going to deliver a speech on the Salt March. As we all know that Mahatma Gandhi, with his 78 volunteers, marched 240 miles from Sabarmati Ashram to Dandi for making salt. Now, you would think why it happened. Before answering this question, I would like to ask one more question to all of you. What is the most important thing in one's food? Of course, it is salt. So, do you know the British government imposed tax on salt and government had monopoly over its production? On 31st January 1930, Gandhiji wrote a letter to Viceroy in Irwin to remove the salt tax, including seven other demands. This letter said that if the demands were not fulfilled by 11th of March, the Congress would launch a civil disobedience campaign. When even Irwin denied, Mahatma Gandhi launched the famous Salt March. This march marked the beginning of civil disobedience movement. The march was over 240 miles from Sabarmati Ashram to Dandi, a coastal town in Gujarat. They walked for 24 days. Thousands come to hear Mahatma Gandhi wherever he stopped. And he told them what he meant by Swaraj and urged them to peacefully defy the British government. On 6th April, he reached Dandi and made salt from seawater, giving a message of non-violence and peace. Once again, I want to wish you all a very happy Gandhi Jayanti. Thank you and Sairam.
Very good. Clap for him. Now, Srishti, Gandhi is biography. Whatever you wanted to speak, you can speak. Srishti Ranjan, it is your time.
Yes, ma'am. Om Shri Sairam, I am Srishti Ranjan. I am going to tell you.
Please listen to me first. All of you can see me.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Srishti, suno. Main pehli baar 6th B mein baithi hu. Mujhe I never handle this. To isliye just puch rahi hu. Srishti, speak like sabse badhiya voice ka jo quality tha uska Priyanka ka tha. So try to maintain that. Theek hai? Chalo.
I am Srishti. I am going to tell you about the life of Mahatma Gandhi. Mahatma Gandhi is also known as Father of a Nation. He was born on October 2, 1869 at Porbandar, Gujarat. His full name was Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi. His father was Dewan of Rajkot. His mother was a religious lady. His wife was Kasturba Gandhi. He passed high school in 1887. He went to London to study law. After returning to India, he fought for the freedom of a country. In 1893, he went to South Africa. In South Africa, he fought for the right of black people. In 1913, Gandhiji returned to India and fought for the freedom of India. In 1920, he started non-cooperation movement. In 1930, he launched civil disobedience movement. In 1942, he started Quit India movement. He went to jail many times. He always believed in truth and non-violence. People believed in his words and followed him. He was killed by Nathuram Godse in 1948 at the age of 78. Thank you.
Good. So quality jo hai na Priyanka jo jaisa boli tumhara bhi acha tha thoda sa maintain kar. Next is his student life. Harshit Jain.
Yes, ma'am. I am Harshit Jain, wanted to present a speech on student life of Mahatma Gandhi. Gandhiji born in Porbandar in 18...
Harshit, yes, I cannot see you.
Ma'am, my camera is on.
Camera to on hai, aap bhi wo jo ek aa raha hai na, bachon ka jo attendance, usko piche ho. Can you shift yourself to the to this side?
Ma'am, it is automatic.
Okay, chalo.
Student life of Mahatma Gandhi. Gandhi ji born in Porbandar in 1869 and received primary education in the city. He was not a bright student and used to learn by writing with his finger in the dust. He moved to Rajkot at the age of 9 when his father took on the role of a counselor to the ruler and later Diwan. Gandhi joined Alfred High School in the city at the age of 11 and even lost a year when he got married at the age of 13. He was noted to be good at English, fair in mathematics, weak in geography, good in conduct and bad in handwriting. The school was later renamed to Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi High School in his memory and shut down in May 2017 after 164 years to make a way of museum. He completed his schooling in Ahmedabad. In 1887, Gandhiji enrolled at Samaldas College, Bhavnagar in 1887 and but left after one term. After formal schooling, he decided that he wanted to be a lawyer. To do this, he had to come to England to enroll at the Inner Temple. He was called to the bar in the summer of 1891. On his return to India, he found that he could not make a successful career as a lawyer, so he moved to South Africa in 1893. In South Africa, he felt discrimination and fought against discrimination, which transformed his life from a meek and unassertive individual to a determined political activist. Then, on 1 year contract to work for an Indian law firm in Natal province, then he took up various grievances on behalf of Indian community and found himself first as advocate on civil rights issues and finally leader in a political movement against racial discrimination and for South Africa Indian rights. After 21 years stay in South Africa, on June 9, 1915, Gandhiji returned to India with his wife. Thank you.
Very good. Now, Shubham thoughts.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Om Shri Sai Ram. Today I am here to share some special thoughts written by Mahatma Gandhi. First, you must be the change you wish to see in the world. It simply means that if you are not happy about anything in your world. Yes, ma'am.
Loud.
Yes, ma'am.
Speak loudly and clearly.
If you are not happy about anything in your world or society, be willing to change it within yourself first. Don't complain. Complaining won't take you anywhere. Remember one thing. Nothing will change unless you will change. Second, the weak can never forgive. Forgiveness is the attribute of the strong. It simply means that it takes courage to forgive someone who has wronged you. Because we are often so caught up in our egos that forgiving seems like losing an egoistic battle. But sometimes, you have to take the high road with forgiveness, both for the other person and for your own well-being. The next thought is, first they ignore you, then they laugh at you, then they fight you, then you win. It simply means that ignore the haters, because once you become successful, the joke will be on them. Out of all famous Mahatma Gandhi quotes, this one is really beautiful as it shows why your haters don't matter. The next thought is,
Why?
Yes, ma'am.
Read it again.
First they ignore you, then they laugh at you, then they fight you, and then you win. It simply means that ignore the haters, because once you become successful, the joke will be on them. Out of all famous thoughts by Gandhiji, this one is really powerful as it shows why your haters don't matter. The next thought is, strength doesn't come from physical capacity. It comes from an indomitable will. It simply means that strength comes when you stand your ground in the face of massive adversity. The size of your biceps doesn't matter. What really matters is the size of your will. And the last thought is, the future depends on what you do today. It simply means that you create your own destiny by mindful of your actions. Thank you.
Good, very good. You must applaud Namita. Next, you need to be in this moment. Abhishek Barkar.
Yes, ma'am.
कट रहा है क्यों?
आवाज कट रही है। यस, कट रही है।
हाँ वही मैं भी बोल रही हूँ, बार बार क्यों बोल रहा है? अब इसे थोड़ा ठीक कर लो बेटा।
यस मैम। द सिविल डिसऑर्डर ऑफ द मोस्ट सिग्निफिकेंट मूवमेंट Yes, freedom struggle. At this 1930s, Congress Party had Swaraj or complete independence. It was civil disobedience movement began with the march. Through tens of thousands of demonstrators. At the moment, the bargaining clause was liquid. Then, used to revenue. Village of, and in many places, forest people violated forest law. Development, the colonial government began arresting the Congress leaders one by one. This led to violent clash use in many places. When Abdul Jafar Khan, a devout disciple, Mahatma Gandhi was arrested in April 1930, facing armed cars police firing. In such situation, Mahatma Gandhi once again to call off the movement and enter a pact with Irwan on 5 March 1931. By this Gandhiji-Irwan pact, Gandhiji consented to participate in a round table conference in London. The government agreed and somebody went to London for the disappointed then India and Jordan had and major fighting Pushing demonstration and boycotts. With a great apprehension, Mahatma Gandhi civil disobedience movement. They were hard hit by the great depression and falling prices.
Have you completed? Abhishek? Have you completed? Next, beta.
No, ma'am.
Tumhara technical problem bahut zyada hai. Abhishek, it is enough, good, but we cannot hear you. Full India Mobile Chesta.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you, bahut acha. You tried, that is very good. मुझे अच्छा लग रहा है।
मेरी आवाज़ है ना? मैं बड़ा है।
सुना? मंत्रा तो। ओम श्री सारम। ओम श्री सारम।
चेस्टर। यस मैम। बाहर आके।
यस मैम।
ये सब एपीआर हो सकता है रिकॉर्डिंग में तुम आ जाओ।
मैम ऑन ही है वीडियो।
है?
वीडियो ऑन ही है।
चेस्टर ईयरफोन लगा लेना आवाज कम आ रही है बहुत ज्यादा।
वो आ गई आ गई चलो। मुंह के पास लो स्पीकर चलो चेष्टा स्टार्ट
ओम श्री साराम टू एवरीवन प्रेजेंट ओवर हियर टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू अबाउट समथिंग अबाउट क्विट इंडिया मूवमेंट द क्विट इंडिया मूवमेंट वाज अ मूवमेंट स्टार्टेड बाय महात्मा गांधी ऑन 8th ऑफ अगस्त 1942 ड्यूरिंग द वर्ल्ड वॉर 2 आस्किंग फॉर एन एंड टू ब्रिटिश रूल इन इंडिया द मूवमेंट वाज स्टार्टेड इन अ स्पीच इन बॉम्बे Where Mahatma Gandhi asked Indians to do or die.
The Congress launched a protest asking the British to withdraw from India. However, the British imprisoned most of the Congress leaderships within a day of speech in an effort to suppress the movement. The British refused to grant independence until the war ended. The movement had three phases. In their first phase, urban revolt marked by strikes, boycott, which were quickly suppressed. There were strikes and demonstrations all over the country, and workers provided their support by not working in the factories. Gandhiji was soon imprisoned at Aga Khan Palace in Pune, and almost all leaders were arrested. In the second phase, the focus shifted to the countryside, which witnessed a major peasant rebellion marked by destructions, communication system such as railway tracks and stations, telegraph wires, and poles attacks on government buildings or any other visible symbols of colonial authority. In their last phase, witnessed the formation of national government isolated pockets. Quit India movement was failed because heavy-handed suppressions, weak coordinations, and a lack of a clear-cut program of actions. However, the British government realized that India was ungovernable in the long run due to the cost of World War II, and the question for post-war became how to exit gracefully and peacefully. In 1992, the Reserve Bank of India issued a 1 rupee coin to mark the golden jubilee of Quit India movement.
Finished. Thank you. Next is Ramit. Where is he?
India.
कहाँ पे? Are you in India?
Yes, ma'am.
I don't see you. तुम्हारा सिंपल से कुछ पता ही नहीं चल रहा कहाँ पे बैठे?
मैम यहाँ पे.
मैम ऑन है उसका वीडियो.
Now okay, I can see him. He was not there. Yes, Ramit. First yes, round. First round table conference. What's your topic? What are you going to talk about?
Ma'am, I am going. Ma'am, I am. My name is Ramesh Sachi Kumar Gailola. I am going to talk about the Simon Commission.
Ramesh, topic kya hai tumhari?
Simon Commission.
Simon Commission. Okay, okay, okay. Simon Commission has nothing to do with Gandhiji. Gandhiji has nothing to do with Simon Commission. Chalo. You speak.
Yes, ma'am.
It the is Simon not regulated in India, but it is nothing, no way it is related to Gandhiji. Is it?
You no, speak. Ma'am. Yes, ma'am. The Simon Commission was a group of seven members of parliament under the chairmanship of Sir John Simon. The commission arrived in British India in 1928 to study the constitutional reforms in Britain's largest and most important procedure. The Government of India Act 1919 has instituted the system of Dryaki to govern the province of British India. The Indian opinion claim.
Why the speaker is not on your mouth? Speaker ko rakho apne mouth ke paas. Now speak.
The Indian opinion clamored for revision for this form of government, and the Government of India Act 1919 itself stated that the commission would be appointed after 10 years to investigate the progress of the government scheme and suggest new steps for reforms in the late 1920. The ruling conservative government feared imminent electoral defeat at the hands of the Labour Party, and also feared the effect of consequent transference of control of India to such an inexperienced body. Yes, yes. Yes, ma'am. Hence, it appointed seven members of parliament to constitute the promises commission to examine the state of Indian constitutional affairs.
Ramit,
The Salmon Commission left England in January 1928. Almost immediately, British arrival in Pondicherry on 4th February 1928, its members were confronted by the protesters. Although there were also some supporters among the crowd who saw it as the next step of the road of self-governance.
I have one more person, Romia, and yes, why? So you finish it quickly. Time more, 4 minutes.
Yes, ma'am. A strike began, and many people turned the greed to commission with black flags. Similar protests occurred in major Indian cities that 7 British MPs visited. The protest against the Simon Commission became infamous on 30 October 1928. The commission arrived at Lahore, where it made the protestants waving black flags. The protest was led by the Indian nationalist Lala Lajpat Rai, who had moved a resolution against the commission in the Legislative Assembly of Punjab in February 1928. In order to make way for the commission, the local police force began beating the protesters. Lala Lajpat Rai was critically injured and died fortnight later. The commission, nahi ma'am, thoda sa baki hai. The commission published its 2-volume report in May 1930. It proposed an abolition of hierarchy and yes, and establishment of representative government in the provinces. It also recommended that separate communal electoral be retained and only the tension between Hindu Muslim had died down. In September 1928, ahead of the commission release, Motilal Nehru represented his Nehru report to counter its charges that India could not find a constitutional consensus among themselves. This report advocated that India must be given dominant status to complete internal self-government. Thank you.
Okay. Now, Romya, it's your turn. Romya?
Okay. Stop. Yes, ma'am. I am Romya Jain, going to present Mahatma Gandhi's letter to Hitler. Basically, Mahatma Gandhi wrote 2 letters to Adolf Hitler. First letter was written on 23rd July 1939, and second letter was written on 24th December 1940. The letter begins from here.
2 minutes are left. Hurry up. Yes, sir. No,
sir. Friends have been urging me to write to you for the sake of humanity, but I have resisted their request because of the feeling that any letter from me would be an impertinence. Something tells me that I must not calculate and that I must make my appeal for whatever it may be worth. It is quite clear that you are today the one person in the world who can prevent a war which may reduce humanity to the savage state. Must you pay that price for an object, however worthy it may appear to you to be? Will you listen to the appeal of one who has deliberately shunned the method of war not without considering the success? Anyway, I anticipate your forgiveness in writing to you.
She is not listening.
Your sincere friend, M.K. Gandhi.
Okay, yes. Hurry up, 2 minutes. 1 minute is there. Are you ready? No line, people of 3 lines, people of 4 lines.
Okay, ma'am. Sri Lal Bahadur Shastri was born to Sharad Prasad Srivastav and Ram Dulari Devi in Mughal Sarai on 2nd October 1904, sharing his birthday with Mahatma Gandhi. He was an Indian politician who served as the second Prime Minister of India. He promoted the White Revolution, a national campaign to increase the production and supply of milk, by supporting the Amul Cooperative of Anand, Gujarat, and creating the National Dairy Development Board. Underlining the need to boost India's food production, Shastri also promoted the Green Revolution in India in 1965. He led to an increase in food grain, especially in Punjab, Haryana, and Uttar Pradesh. He led the country during the Indo-Pakistan War of 1965. His slogan, Jai Jawan, Jai Kisan, became very popular during the war. The war normally ended with the Tashkent Agreement on 10 January 1966. He died the following day. Still in Tashkent, with the cause of his death is in dispute. It was reported to be a cardiac arrest, but his family was not satisfied with the reason. Thank you.
Okay, okay. Did you like the class?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Every day we study, but today, I will appreciate your effort like anything. आप लोग धीमे धीमे को बोलो बट यू डिड सो वेल. हाँ बोलो श्रेया, क्या बोल रहे थे?
कुछ नहीं मैम.
ओके बाय देन, वी डू समथिंग बट
मैम आप रिकॉर्डिंग ऑफ कर दीजिए. आप ऑफ कर दीजिए, वो सेव नहीं होगी.
मैम अगर आप ऑफ करेंगी तब वो यूट्यूब पे जाएगा, नहीं तो नहीं जाता यूट्यूब पे.
जाता है बराबर. वो लोग डाउनलोड करते हैं अभी पहले. अभी 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 शांति पाठ तो करे. नेक्स्ट आइटम ये ऑफ करने से
जाएगा. हाँ जितने भी वीडियोस हम लोग ने ऑफ किया है और आपने लीव किया है तो नहीं किया यूट्यूब पे.
स्टॉप रिकॉर्डिंग करो.
यस मैम कर दीजिए.
यस मैम.
ओके चलिए हम ओंकारम करें, शांति पाठ करें. शांति शांति शांति.